Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1649. How can I buy PowerPivot 2013? Hey everyone, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm reporting live from Bellevue, Washington here at the MVP Summit. I have what I think is some important news. We've been frustrated over the last week or so because the amount of complexity in buying Office 2013 is tremendous. You know, I'm a small business, so I go out to Amazon.com. They have the Home and Student, the Home and Business, Office Pro. And if you've been watching the podcast, you've seen me talk about products such as PowerPivot, PowerView. I'm going to show GeoFlow soon, maybe Inquire. There's all these great add-ins, and I want to make sure that I can get those add-ins. You say, well, wait, PowerPivot was free in Excel 2010. I just had to go download it. Well, no, not anymore. You need a version of Office that includes that add-in. You can't just go download it for free anymore. And when we started looking into this, we were slightly horrified that all of those offerings at Amazon did not include PowerPivot, PowerView, GeoFlow, and Inquire. And back in Excel 2003, that's the last time that Microsoft made this colossal mistake of separating out some features in Excel. You could go buy the standalone boxed edition and it would include all that stuff, but the standalone boxed edition at Amazon does not include the good stuff. Well, I mean, it includes lots of good stuff. It includes VLOOKUP and charting and all the usual stuff, but it doesn't include PowerPivot, PowerView, GeoFlow, and Inquire. Microsoft wants you to start renting software. I have a problem with renting software. Right now, hey, times are good. I'm selling books. Everything is great. I'm happy to pay $399 right now and know that I'll have a version of Office that I can use forever. I don't want to pay some smaller amount and have to pay that again and again and again. Maybe in a couple of years, but I won't be buying books and I won't have the money to go out and buy Office. I really like just buying the DVD and knowing that I can use it forever. So you'll see Office 365 Home Premium. Heck, I've pitched Office 365 Home Premium. I spent a lot of podcasts on that. I had asked the question and they never answered. Well, now I learn. Home Premium does not include the good stuff. You have to go to Office 365 midsize, the E3 plan, $240 a year to get the good stuff. By the way, that's not coming out till February 27th, and today is February 19th or February 20th, depending on when we get this posted. Yeah, that really is a long pause because I just don't know what to say. My friends who create Excel did not do this, right? They're engineers. They created great products. I appreciate those products. You'll see me rave about those products. It's someone else high up who puts the packages together who made what I believe to be the world's worst mistake right here. The world's worst mistake? Boy, that's pretty serious. Well, certainly in the top five. Okay, now, here's the thing. They say, well, you can go out and do volume licensing. Volume licensing, if you get Office 2013 Pro Plus, then you get PowerPivot, PowerView, GeoFlow, and Inquire. And if you go to volume licensing and buy Excel 2013 standalone, right now it just has Excel, but soon we'll be putting out an update that has PowerPivot, PowerView, GeoFlow, and Inquire. But my rebuttal is, yet to get volume licensing, I have to buy five copies. Now, I don't know what the volume licensing price is, but let's just estimate it's $399 times 5. That means I have to spend $2,000 to get PowerPivot, PowerView, GeoFlow, and Inquire. Well, hey, they're good products. But if I'm just using PowerPivot to get, to calculate a range or, max X minus min X, that seems like a pretty steep price. But now, I need to send a shout out to Ken Puls from excelguru.ca. Ken is another MVP. Ken knows about volume licensing, and he has cracked the code. To get into volume licensing, you don't have to buy five copies of Office. You have to buy five licenses. And Ken tipped me off. I downloaded the entire 176-page list of volume licensing. Ken suggested buy one copy of Office 2013 Pro Plus and four copies of Windows Vista DVD Playback Pack. These are about $9 each. So now I pay for Office. Great. I pay a $36 upcharge just to get around the ridiculous licensing schemes that they have. I could do that. So let's say $399 for Office Pro, $36 for the 4 copies of this completely useless software. By the way, hey, if this catches on, Microsoft will be really perplexed when this product starts becoming their bestseller, because everyone starts buying 4 of them just to get Office Pro Plus as a volume licensing customer. How do you become volume licensing? Just go search for Microsoft volume licensing. Pretty easy. There's a find a vendor. You know, I looked around my zip code, and there's a company just 5 miles away. Give them a call. Say, hey, I want to become a volume licensing customer. I'm ready to buy 5 licenses. 1 license of Office 2013 Pro Plus, and I watch a lot of DVDs. I need 4 licenses of this DVD software. You'll be good to go. Should it be this hard? No, it absolutely should not. This is silos. You know, large companies have silos. There's one department that does this, and another department does this, and they don't communicate well. Here we have an example of where the people that put the packages together completely missed the fact that the Pro DVD needs to include those 4 add-ins. But for right now, thanks to Ken Puls, we have a workaround. Check out excelguru.ca. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.